It's the 2K Sports pregame show.
Are you ready to rise to the challenge here on the Rising Stars Challenge? Then come to 2K Sports. On behalf of the Diesel, Shaquille O'Neal, and Kenny the Jet Smith, I'm Ernie Johnson. Tonight, it'll be the elites going up against the stars. They're looking to come out strong and make their mark early. They have to look at this game as a great opportunity to do just that. And another of our fabulous all-star events, the Rising Stars Challenge. Teams composed entirely of first and second year players. Shaq, what does this game mean to these young fellas?
Welcome to the NBA Rising Stars Challenge, a game that has become such a special part of all-star festivities. With Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg, I'm Kevin Harlan.
And that's really because it always provides us with such an entertaining look at the next generation of NBA stars. In a game like this where the pressure's off and it's all about having fun, I think we really get an opportunity to see just how skilled these young players are.
Exactly. I mean, nobody's going to get on top of you if you go behind your back or you try something out of the ordinary. And that means we get to see these young guys pull off some amazing plays in this game every year.
Along with Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg, this is Kevin Harlan. All fueled up and ready to go. Let's check out who's on the floor, courtesy of Gatorade. On the court for the Stars, Miles out there with Johnson. Then there's Okafor. Then it's Moutier. And it's Booker in at the shooting guard.
And it's just something about the Rising Stars Challenge. It gives each of these young players a chance to really do something special on a national stage, maybe for the first time in their professional career. And guys, since this game started back in 94, this has been a perfect warm-up for the All-Star Game. I mean, it has all the fun and excitement of the big game with the added element of introducing some of the great young stars to the league's fame. And as usual, neither team really grinding too hard at the defensive end.
And I think that's okay in this event. I mean, I say the more highlights, the better.
Now here's Booker. Pass to Moutier. He kicks to Booker. No one near him. And it's Russell with the rebound. This really has become one of the signature events of All-Star Week. I know you love it, Greg. It gets everyone into the mood for all the festivities that are soon to come.
Yeah, it does. I mean, it's such a great way for these young players to show off some of the fancy moves that they wouldn't even dare to attempt in a regular season game.
Elites on D. 6-point game. Now, here's Moutier, guarded closely. 13 feet away. Good. Okafor's got his first basket.
You can't give him that shot. A few open looks are all it takes.
Doris Burke spoke with head coach Fred Hoiberg. What'd you find out, DB?
We talked about his roster of players for the Rising Stars Challenge, and he said, I look at this group, and top to bottom, this could be the players who are the faces of the NBA in a few years. Everyone here just oozes talent and will be dominating the league in a short time. He just might be right, guys.
All right, Doris, thank you very much. Now, here's Moutier. He's guarded by Russell. Miles passes to Okafor. The shot is off. Now the elites take it the other way. Now the feed to Wiggins. They get the rebound. Porzingis powered down with both hands.
And just another example, Kevin, of how they built this lead, just outworking.
Greg, that was definitely an effort play right there. You talk about that all the time, fighting to get proper position, then slamming home the putback.
Yep, and if they can maintain this energy level, their lead will be safe.
Moutier with the basket. And here in the first, about 3 minutes in,
I love this event so much because it combines the world-class ability of these players with the freedom of the playground.
Yep, it's the greatest and certainly the most fun pickup game these players will ever play in.
Here's Moutier after the made shot from Karl Anthony Towns. No one near Moutier as he lets it go. And then Okafor slams it in.
Just a terrific effort on the offensive glass. That's how they're going to cut into this lead.
And Greg, a dunk like that is sure to give them a spark.
Which is a spark they desperately need, Kevin. They've got to ramp up the intensity.
Oh, you've got to be able to deliver when you get a bunny like that. That's just too easy of a shot to miss.
Fades back. Rebounded by Hood.
You know, the right thing there to try to fade away with the D all over, but that is a difficult shot to sink.
Passes it to Porzingis. Cannot hit. Now the Stars take it the other way. And the pass to Lyles. It's good with the assist that time from Johnson. Lyles got his second basket of the night.
That's a quick bucket there. Solid in transition.
Well, you know, he loves the chance to get out and run, and we could see right there why he does.
And it's a completely new group for the Elites, and a new group getting ready now for the Stars. 102 left to play in the first. On left of the wing, here's Clarkson. From outside, off the mark. The Stars trail by four. Feeds to Randall. And the rebound goes to the Elites. Here's Ingles. The Elites with another miss. Nato covered by Payton. Here the step back. Johnson attacking. They shoot again. And it's good on the layup.
And we haven't seen very much of him in the regular season yet. But there's no question he's got a very bright future ahead of him.
I agree with all of that. Even with limited playing time, his talent has been evident. And that talent is strong enough to have earned him a spot in this game. And that says a lot considering he doesn't play a bunch for his team.
Mirotic's shot is off. Here's Galloway. 1 second left. And it's blocked. And that goes out of bounds. No key possession. At the end of one, a closely contested game so far. Welcome back, everyone, to the Rising Stars Challenge, where the NBA's youngest, brightest stars take the stage.
And it's not hard to tell just how much fun these young guys are having out there tonight.
That's exactly right. And the same goes for the fans. I mean, they're having a blast, too. What a terrific event this has been.
We've got Nikola Mirotic. Alfred Payton is out there with Clarkson. Then there's Yusuf Nurkic, and it's Ingles in at the three. That's the group for the Elites to start this second quarter.
Yeah, a little light on the fouls in terms of what's been called tonight, and that's usually the theme in this game.
I agree. I mean, the guys always... reasonably hard, but they don't necessarily play physically, if that makes any sense. The officials' jobs are usually pretty easy in this one.
And not as many turnovers as we often get in this game, so good to see both teams taking care of the ball.
Yeah, it really is. I mean, surprisingly, very well controlled for the most part. Sometimes things get a little wild out there, but not so here.
And some changes here for the Elites. Towns, he's checked in for Nurkic. Porzingis comes in for Joe Ingles. And Andrew Wiggins is subbed in for Payton. The Elites leading. Porzingis passes to Clarkson. And some very quick points for him on that possession.
and good passing setting up a lot of these buckets right now, Kevin. That's been the key.
Dime dropping delights is what I call it.
Yeah, it's a nice pass. I will give you that one.
Yep, he's on the money, that's no doubt. And the basket by Kaminsky.
You know, what an advantage he brings to this offense, guys. I mean, being able to drain the three ball, that really can spread a defense and extend the defense as well.
Wiggins dishes to Miritich. That falls. Nice feed that time from Wiggins. Miritich has got his first bucket of the night. And here are the Stars now, trailing by two. Here's Moutier. No good. Now the Elites take it the other way. Wiggins kicks to Miritich. No luck. So it's the Stars now. Dishes to Kaminsky. Kicks to Okafor. And it's blocked. Wiggins outside. Inside. Porzingis. That's good. And it's his fourth basket of the game. He's a strong 4-for-6. And what's your take, guys, in the hustle stats for the Elites?
Well, in the first half of play, they're closing out aggressively, blocking shots, a key indicator of their activity on the defensive side.
Another big aspect of their game tonight has been the fast break, transition opportunities. They're really keeping it up tempo so far.
And some changes here for the Elites. Rodney Hood comes in for Miritich. And it's Russell in for Clarkson. The Stars also with a sub. Lyles check in for Johnson. A little under 2.5 minutes gone by here in the second quarter. Lyles no good.
And he thought he had a clear path to the hoop, but the defense did give up on that play and cut him off.
And it's Wiggins with the jam.
Tell you what, he can do a lot.
And you know, Clark, with the lead they're enjoying, I'm surprised he didn't put a little something extra on that one.
Me too.
Well, I'll tell you what, I'm glad he didn't, because otherwise we'd probably have a 45-minute delay here if he shattered the backboard.
The Elites leading by 6. He dishes it to Towns. About 3 minutes played so far in the second quarter.
Good!
And they can up the ante a little bit there after that basket.
Yeah, you know, their lead's increasing, and they've got to be feeling better and better about the way this game is starting to play out now. So we'll see if they can close it out.
Here's Moutier after the made shot from Carl Anthony Towns. Moutier passed to Okafor. Pulled the shot a little up, but the bounce goes his way. Okafor's got 6.
Excellent assist there. Just led him to the perfect spot. And did not seem happy about how things are going on right now, and maybe wants to make some changes.
I agree. I mean, just was not comfortable with the way things were set up at that particular time. And in that case, I think it's the right thing to do.
And the Elites making a change here. Nurkic just checked in.
And that's the shot he has to take.
Exactly. That's the right look. The decision was good. He just didn't execute.
The Stars have gone 1-for-1, making their previous attempt at the line. The first one falls. Alfred Payton, he's checked in for Wiggins. The Stars also with a sub. Pauly Stein's checked in. Both free throws good from Booker.
And what an advantage. You really feel like you can always trust him when he's at the line.
Payton, that's good. We've got 1:13 left to play here in the half. Pass to Lyles. The dish to Galloway. And that one ends up out of bounds. And they retain possession.
Yeah, that's a super defensive play. If that gets through, no doubt they score.
And that's why he sold out for it, because he knew he had to make that play. He wasn't going to let them get the advantage.
The Stars making a switch here. Randall's checked in. Here's Galloway. He hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. Here's Cauley Stein, and he uses the glass on the layup.
Really strong rebounding on the interior, and he gets the easy putback.
Pass to Nurkic. Out to the right wing. Here's Hood, and he makes good on his first shot of the game.
Get him. better and better. Got that field goal percentage up in the 60s now.
Clark, they dialed it in here in the second quarter, playing really well.
Rolly Stein kicks to Randall. There's a good screen. He feeds it to Galloway. Passes it to Cauley Stein. Shot clock at 5. Randall dishes to Galloway. Baseline jumper. And he gets it to go.
Wow, risky shot there size-wise, but the incredible skill that he possesses allows that one to go.
Well, the quick high release negated any height disadvantage he had right there.
And Towns gets it to go.
I like the recognition of the mismatch there, immediately making the defense pay.
The pass to Lyons. A terrific shot on the turnaround. Lyles got 6 points.
Wow, he was just wide open there. That's way too easy.
Here's Payton. Oh, and he just knocked down the buzzer beater.
How about that one? A perfect finish to the half for them to tack another 3 points onto their lead.
And so we wrap up the first half.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
And in this complete the Rising Stars game, a beloved tradition in the NBA, and tonight, a game to recognize the amazing young talent that's recently joined the league. This event, guys, probably one of my favorites, and the fans love it too.
There is always.
And that'll wrap up our halftime.
Welcome back to the Rising Stars Challenge, a showcase for the up-and-coming stars of the NBA.
And what a showcase this game has been for the league's best and brightest young stars.
And you know, one of my favorite things is seeing the camaraderie between the players. I mean, both of these teams really enjoying playing together and against each other.
Tipping off the second half, here's Fred Hoiberg's 5. Johnson is out there with Lyles. Then it's Moutier. Then there's Okafor. And it's Booker in at the 2. Now, here's Moutier. They set the pick. The Stars need to get off a shot. Poke loose.
You almost have to assume he's going to knock those down when he is that open.
Here's Ingles. Towns, the pass to Clarkson. Sinks it from just inside the baseline. Clarkson's got the first points to start out the third quarter. For the elites. The Stars trail by 9 to the paint. Puts it up from 12. Green for 2 points. Parsons got his third bucket of the night.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Well, when you look at the assist totals, heck, they've been clearly the better team.
Here's Nurkic. He's tightly guarded. That's good. 10 points for Carl Anthony Towns.
The second half has started quite well. They've been good on 3 of their first 4 attempts.
Timeout called here, the first for the Stars.
Yeah, none too pleased with the play of this team. And you know what? They just need to get things sorted out.
Yeah, you know, there's not a coach around who would be happy with the way his guys have kind of rolled over during this run.
Kaminsky, he's checked in for the Stars. Now, here's Moutier. Parked down low that time, and he got the 3-second call.
Not doing them any favors with those kinds of errors.
Especially now, Greg, with every possession being so crucial.
And the elites with some changes. Zingas checked in for Jusuf Nurkić. Mirotić Miletich comes in for Joe Ingles, and Andrew Wiggins is subbed in for Russell. And Okafor slams it in.
There's that transition offense. Push the ball up the floor. The defense can't get set up. You can get some easy hoops that way.
And that steal made it possible. And if they can use a few more sequences just like that.
Towns, no luck. The Stars trail by 11. Now, here's Moutier. Johnson outside. Down low, 11 feet away, off the left rim and out.
Well, he just hasn't looked right to me. A bit out of sorts, if you will. Something's off with his mechanics, at least as I look at it.
And can you always depend on him or what to lead you to the right place with that pass? Money.
Joe Ingles is checked in for the Elites. Langston Galloway's checked in for the Stars. The Elites shooting their third free throw attempt of the game. Free throw good, Wiggins. A little over 2.5 minutes off the clock in this final half of play. Picked by Okafor. Here's Moutier. And he didn't get quite enough under that one.
Boy, there was no hand in his face right there. I thought for sure he was going to knock that down.
There's the bucket. Good. The Elites lead by 16. And the Stars have possession. Picked by Okafor. Shoots off the screen. Moutier, no good.
You know what? He's just stone cold right now. Really not sure if he's their best option offensively as they try to get back in this game.
And play stops as it looks like they called over the back here.
You know, right call. Gave the officials no choice there. I mean, they've got to make that call over the back.
Yeah, I mean, he went chest first into the man in front of him. My goodness, I'm not an official, and I could have gotten that one right.
Russell, he's checked in for Andrew Wiggins.
He thought he had that one clean, but the ref saw it differently. They'll count the basket.
Here's Russell. And it comes off the front of the rim. The Stars trail by 14. Now the feed to Johnson. For the three. The Elites pull it in.
I tell you what, you can shake your confidence missing wide open shots like that.
Here's Russell. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two. The Elites shooting their fourth and fifth attempts at the free throw line tonight. And the first one drops. And so Russell hits them both. 1:12 left in the third. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've had a number of empty ones, a long time without a basket.
They got to find something, you're right. Deal. Towns with it, out defended by Randall. Here's Porzingis, hands the 12-footer. Porzingis has got 10. And guys, what do you think about the hustle stats here for the Elites?
Boy, they're hounding, harassing effort at the defensive end. Very impressive, and they forced quite a few turnovers as a result.
And also, how about the points they've gotten in transition on the fast break tonight? That's been a huge factor as well.
Here are the Elites now. They're on a 15-6 run. Ingles passes to Porzingis to the middle. It's tipped. And taken away by Johnson. And now here's Johnson, the fast break chance. And the shot is good. Galloway has got his second bucket of the night.
Another bucket in the paint. That's something they just have not been able to stop today.
Yeah, the defense is all about disrupting timing and spacing. And what they've got going right now is not getting it done.
The Stars have made 3 free throws so far. Haven't missed any. And the first one at the line is good.
Substitution on the court.
And good on the second, so he makes them both. 12 seconds left to play in the third. Feeds it to Nurkic. Back to Mirotić. Out to the wing. Here's Payton. He got it up in time, but it wouldn't fall for him. And as we end the third quarter, a double-digit deficit. And we now return to the Rising Stars Challenge, a great night for young fans and the best young players in the NBA.
Oh, to be young and athletic, just a ton of energy out there on the floor tonight.
Yeah, you know, like we see every year, these young guys are super excited to be playing in this game, and that excitement comes out onto the court.
Nurkic is out there with Mirotić, then it's Wiggins, then there's Elfrid Payton, and it's Hood in at the shooting guard position. That's the group on the floor for the elites. Now, here's Moutier. You know what? Great D that time from Payton.
With the success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect them to be, firmly in control of this game.
And no doubt about it, rebounding is an effort stat, folks. They've been... more determined than their opponent thus far.
Now here's Moutier, covered by Payton. Moutier kicks to Okafor, shoots from the baseline. That's all good, and that's his fifth basket of the game. He's shooting 5 for 11 now.
Just no chance for the smaller defender to block that shot.
He's really, really good at using his size to free himself up for those mid-range jumpers. Master it.
And he gets it to go. And that's 13 points for Andrew Wiggins.
And when they've gone to him, he has come through big time. You got to keep getting him touches.
Now a timeout called by the Stars. And the elites making a change here. Towns has checked in. The Stars also with the sub. Johnson, he's checked in for Kaminsky. And here's Moutier. Here's Lyles. Picked by Okafor. And there's the foul. It'll go on Nikola Mirotić. That's his first foul. Porzingis, he's checked in for Mirotić.
Substitution for your niece. Kristaps Porzingis.
Here's Booker. No good on the quick three.
You know what, though? Sometimes you can be too open. I think it may have surprised him, and that's why he missed.
Payton outside. The shot. The rebound by Johnson. The Stars trail by 17. He kicks to Moutier. Corner shot. And that one's good.
Booker with the bucket.
One thing we've seen from these guys is excellent ball movement.
And you love to see that, Kevin. I mean, I love watching unselfish play, and I know Greg enjoys that too.
No doubt about it. It's fun to watch the way they're operating as a team right now. They are all in sync.
Now, here's Moutier. Kicks to Okafor, and it's blocked.
It's a +5 advantage for them in the rebounding category after that board.
Very steady with their work on the interior. Really a well-rounded effort overall.
Good on the shot. And the elites lead by 17. Just under 2.5 minutes gone here in the final quarter. There's the pick. Moutier kicks to Okafor. It's rebounded by the elites. Towns has got rebound number 5 here tonight. Here's Hood. The Stars with the rebound. They push it up 4-on-3. Here's Lyles. Bounces high off the rim and drops.
Excellent assist there. Just led him to the perfect spot.
The elites leading by 15. Here's Porzingis. Now that is his 7th field goal in 10 tries. He he's shooting a very good 70%.
And really, with every point from this point on, it seems like they're just closer to finishing this one off.
If they haven't already done it. I mean, hey, it's been a tremendous all-around performance from this group. I don't think there's any question about that.
And really, just unselfish basketball on the interior. That's the kind of pass a coach loves to see.
Russell, he's checked in for the Elites. And so, here are the Elites. They led by as many as 18 points. Here's Towns, and a strong finish with two hands.
Kevin, I tell you what, when he gets to the rim like that, he's really hard to stop.
Yeah, he can get up a few notches higher, there's no doubt.
And that's how the game is played on the inside. You can play over the top. You've got a great advantage.
Moutier shoots from 14, and the ball ends up out of bounds. And they'll keep possession. And the Elites will go with a different look here. Nurkic checked in for Towns. Irotic comes in for Porzingis. Joe Ingles, he's checked in for Wiggins. And it's Payton in for Russell. And a little over 3.5 minutes in the books so far here in the fourth.
You've got to give them a lot of credit for the job they've done on the backboard.
They've done a lot of things well today, but really it's about what they've done on the backboard that's at the top of that.
The Stars trail by 19. Nato, covered by Payton. Dishes it to Galloway. Pass to Kaminsky. But Trey, they get it again. Here's Randle. And you can count it. He'll go to the line with a chance to make it three.
Just not enough bodies on the glass right there, and they paid for it.
Well, Greg, I know you're a little guy, but you know what it means to box out, and it's an effort thing and a mindset deal. You got to get your body between that other player and the ball.
...52 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Here's Ingles. That's good. And it's Payton with the assist.
Just look at how quickly the lead has grown here over the last few possessions.
Clear case here, partner, of saving their best for last. Quite a run.
Now here's Randle. Here's Galloway. Trying to come right back with a three of his own, but it's no good. About 7 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Nurkic lets it go from the baseline and nails it. And the Elites lead by 21.
The shooting percentage continues to elevate here in the second half.
Well, as a group, they've been harmonic since the break. In sync. Good team basketball resulting in high-quality shots.
Payton dishes to Nurkic. Here's Clarkson. That one bounces around and comes back out. So it's the Elites winning this one easily.
What a terrific game. I tell you what, these young players are going to give us years of excitement to come. The future of the NBA is looking very bright with these guys, Kevin.
Terrific young players. It sure is. You're right.
The 2K Sports post-game show.
Kevin, thank you, and now we get a...
I can't imagine a player having a better night from the field than he had tonight. His shooting percentage was off the charts. He used every trick in the book to get those high percentage shots. He shot from every direction, and there was a little bit of luck here and there, but he was on fire.
Well, as Dr. O'Neill predicted, I knew he'd be the star of the Rising Stars Challenge this year. Told you that 10 times already, Kenny. So much great young talent on the floor, but this kid stole the show with the display he put on.
And that wraps up our coverage of the Rock.